Hello students, once again welcome back to the class of physics. So we started to solve numericals related to thermodynamics. Now we will continue those numericals. So in the last class we have done till I think 5 numericals we solved in the previous class. Now I am going to solve another one, that is of 6th one. So what I am doing is I am solving different types of numericals. Maybe the product which we are going, sorry, the result or the answer what we are going to find at the end may be same, but the method which we are using here in this, all the problems are different. Okay, so let us take an example of question number 6. It's a very simple question, even though solution is also very simple. So how to solve this, sir? See, just look at the question once. So there we have a cornered engine and its efficiency is given. So that is eta value is given. How much it is? 0.4. It converts 300 joules to useful work. That is the amount of work done is given. Trouble is equals to how much? 3000 joules. Sorry. Wait a second. Whether it is 3000 or 300? Yes, it is 3000 joules. And what is the quantity of heat absorbed? So what you need to find here, you have to find the value of, sorry, you need to find the value of amount of heat absorbed, that is Q1. Q1 value is supposed to find. See, if you want to find the value of Q1, what is the expression? What are all the formulas that we have here? So we have work done is equals to what? Actually, we can write it as Q1 minus Q2. So work done we know, Q1 we need to find, but we don't know what is the value of Q2. So similarly, then what to do, sir? Let's go for another other numericals. What is the another quantity which is given here in this question? Efficiency. So what is the expression for efficiency? We have different formulas. So I'll write here. See, efficiency eta is equals to work done by Q1. That also can write it as Q1 minus Q2 divided by Q1. And that is equals to T1 minus T2, or we can also 1 minus T2 by T1. These are all the formulas that we have here in this case of to find the value of efficiency. But here we don't need to find the value of efficiency. But what you need to find? You need to find the value of amount of heat absorbed. So here work done value, you know, eta value, you know. So what you need to find? Q1. So take this formula. Leave this. So if you take this formula, so what you can write? Work done is equals to what? Sorry, Q1, you can send it here and bring this efficiency value here. So Q1 is equals to W by eta. That is nothing but efficiency. What is the value of work done? It is 3000 joules divided by, what is the expression for? What is the value of efficiency now? We have 0.4. So you can add another 0. So what you will get? So the quantity of heat absorbed is given by, let me check the answer, it is given by 7500 joules, or we can write it as into 10. So here you'll get 4, you can add one more 0 here. So what you can do is 0.4, or you can write directly, no, I hope so, because without calculator you can do it. So you can write it as 330,000 divided by 4. So 4 ones are 2 remaining. So 4 5s are 20 00. So 7500 joules. You get 7500 joules is the amount of heat absorbed by the Carnot engine. So we can say the amount of heat sent from the sink is how much? So heat maintained at the sink is of around 7500 joules. So that will be the answer. This is the solution for question number 6. See, just read, see the question. See, we have, people will get confused suddenly if they write this equation. Okay, you have, the hint will be given in every question. The thing is, you must know which formula you are supposed to take. See here, eta and W is given. Put the expression for efficiency, what and all the expression that you have. In that, you can compare the things which you need to find out. So which formula is relevant for that particular given data that you take and solve, you will get the answer. It's very easy, no need to worry. Even the next numerical also, it is of same kind. So now, see, just see the second question. So that is nothing but question number 7. So what is question number 7? We have Carnot heat engine working between 127 degrees Celsius and 27 degrees Celsius. So here they have not mentioned what is the temperature of the source and what is the temperature of the sink, but it is understood that so temperature value is high. That means what? It is the temperature of the source, because we know that in the theory concept we studied, the source is maintained with very high temperature than that of the sink. Correct. Now let us take, so T1 I'll write it as 127 degrees Celsius. So 127 degrees Celsius, that means what? 127 plus, you need to convert this into Kelvin, so add 273, you know the conversion. So what you will get? You will get around 300 plus 400 Kelvin. 400 Kelvin is the temperature of the source. Meanwhile, temperature of the sink is given by 27 degree Celsius, that is given by 27 plus 273, which is given by 300 Kelvin. So the temperature of the source as well as sink we got. Now continue the question. Absorbs 2000 joules of source per cycle. 2000 joules from the source per cycle. That means the amount of heat absorbed, Q1 is given. How much? 2000 joules. 2000 joules is the amount of heat absorbed per cycle. So what you need to find now? So you need to find the value of the quantity of heat is subjected, or we can say the quantity of heat is rejected or sent. Anything, it's up to you. We can consider whatever you want. But the thing is, amount of heat sent to the sink, or amount of heat subjected, amount of heat rejected, anything, all are give us same meaning. Now, what is the relation we have? So Q1, I'll take this formula, Q1 by Q2 is equals to T1 by T2, because you need to find the value of Q2, right? So why, sir, how you took this one? Because not in the previous problem, before that we solved on numericals. So there we found the value of ratio of source to the sink, but there they have not given the value of heat. Okay, sorry, temperature of source from the sink we need to find. So we found in the previous problem, but there they have not given the value of temperature, but what is the value that you had now? So there you know the values of heat in the source as well as in the sink. So there we took the ratio and we have equated that equation to this, then we got the value as, and we simplified and we got the expression. So similarly, you need to find the value of Q2 now. So Q2 is equals to what? So cross multiply, take this into the RHS and bring this into the LHS. So Q1 into T2 divided by T1, because here we know the value of Q1, we know the value of T1, and also we know the value of T2. Substitute all the values. So when you substitute all the values, Q1 value is how much? That is 2000 joules into, what is the value of T2 here? T2 value is 300 Kelvin. So 300 Kelvin divided by, what is the value of T1 here? Sorry. T1 here how much? Yeah. T1 400 Kelvin. So 0, 0, 2 zeros got cancelled. So 4 ones are 4 fives are 500 into 3. So how much you get? 1500 joules. So this will be the amount of heat sent to the sink. The amount of heat sent to the sink, or we can say the amount of heat subjected is how much? 1500 joules. So this is the required solution for this particular question. Okay, go through with the solution and you just simplify. I did randomly. If you will get some other answer, please let me know. But this will be the right answer. You do the calculation because you have a calculator in your house, so that you can take and you can solve and you can write the final answer. Okay, now let us move on to the third question. See, what is given in this third question? See, Carnot engine absorbs 1000 joules of heat from the reservoir at 127 degrees Celsius. So Carnot engine absorbs Q1 amount of heat from the source, or in general we can call it as a reservoir. What is the amount of heat? That is 1000 joules. What is the temperature of that particular reservoir is given as 127 degree Celsius. In other words, we can write it as 400 Kelvin, because 127 into 273, you will get it as 400 Kelvin. Okay, so now similarly, and rejects 600 joules of heat during each cycle. That means Q2 value is also given. How much it is? 600 joules. So what are all the things that you are supposed to find out here in this given question? See, we need to find the value of, first one is what? Efficiency. Second one is temperature of the sink. And third one is amount of useful work done. So it's very easy, only if you know the formulas. I have already given the list of formulae. Just go through with that, then you will understand. See, what is the first one? Efficiency you need to find. Eta value you are supposed to find. Then second one, temperature of the sink. That is nothing but T2. T2 also you need to find. Similarly, amount of work done. W is also you are supposed to find. So before going to that, you must know, before solving the numericals, before going to start the numerical, you must know the formulas of each required parameters. So what are all the formulas that we have now? Okay, so let me write the solution here. So I'll write the required things here. So what you need to find, eta this much, and also you need to find the value of temperature of the sinks. T2 is equals to, we don't know, so that is also we need to find. So amount of work done. So these are the required things we are supposed to find here in this given question. So the next one is efficiency. See, what are all the formulas are there to find the value of efficiency? So we know T1, Q1 and Q2, and you can easily, if you know the value of Q2 and Q1, then you can easily find the value of efficiency, correct? So what is the formula that we have to find the value of efficiency? Which is given by 1 minus Q2 by Q1, correct? Or 1 minus T2 by T1. So Q2 by Q1 value, how much it is? It is 600 by 1000. 600 by 1000 is nothing but 1 by 6 you will get. 1 minus 1 by 6, or 6 minus 1, 5 by 6 you will get the value as 0.40 something you will get. Okay, so now let me find the value of T2 first. I'll just find the value of T2. So I'll take the relation. So Q1 by Q2 is equals to T1 by T2. So we know the value of Q1, we know the value of Q2, and also we know the value of T1. So T2 you need to find. T2 is equals to what? T1 into Q2 divided by Q1. So that is given by, so what is the formula that we have now? Wait a minute, yeah, it's proper. So T1 into Q2 by Q1. So T1 is how much here? Sorry, 400 Kelvin. So 400 into, what is the value of Q2? It is 600 divided by, what is the value of Q1 now we have? It is nothing but 1000. So 1000, so 2020 get the answer. This is 10. So 64 is 24. So you will get the value of T4 as 240 Kelvin. 240 Kelvin is the value of T2. So we got the value of T2 now. So next we can easily find the value of efficiency. So how to find the value of efficiency? Eta is equals to, let me check whether it is coming on the screen or not. Yes, we can. So eta is equals to 1 minus T2 by T1. So efficiency is given by 1 minus, what is the value of T2 now here? 240 divided by T1 is how much? There it is, 400. So 0 get cancelled. So 40 minus 24 divided by 40, you will get 16 divided by 40. 16 divided by 40, you will get approximately of around 4 are 16 you will get. I think if you simplify, okay, here only I do. 4 tens are, 4 6 are, 2 3s are, 2 5s are. So 5 minus 2, 5 minus 3, 2, 2 divided by 5. So how much you will get? 0.20, 5 4s are 20. So 0.4 is the efficiency of the given Carnot engine. efficiency of the given Carnot engine, or we can write it as 40%. 40% is the efficiency of the given Carnot engine. Similarly, what else you need to find? You got the value of T2 now, efficiency also we got. Next, what you need to find? You need to find the value of work done. So work done, now we can easily find out. Work done, what is the formula? That is given by Q1 minus Q2. Q1 value, you know, what is the value of Q1? It is here only it's given, that is 1000 minus, what is the value of Q2 now? Q2 value is how much? 2 value given as 600 joules, that is 600. So you got the answer as 400 joules is the amount of work done in a given Carnot cycle. Okay, so in a given Carnot engine. So this is all about the three numericals which we solved today. So this is very, very important. Just go through with these numericals and write down all the numericals in your notebook, and in the next video we'll solve some other numericals, and also meanwhile I'll give some problems for you to solve. Okay, go through with this.